Item number, SCP-090, Object Class, Keter. Special Containment Procedures. Artifact is to be held in a secure bunker in the facility at site and constantly monitored by approved Class D personnel. The object's new arrangement is to be imaged every time it shifts. New arrangements are fed into the facility's Class OT supercomputer. Division Chief is to be notified of all changes in current estimates every half hour. No personnel is to touch SCP-090, except under order undisclosed. AXA security level has been created for monitoring SCP-090. Non-AXA personnel found in the facility will be terminated. Description: SCP-090 was located and retrieved in an undisclosed location on April 10th, 19. Prior to retrieval, SCP-090 had been located in a chamber at the nearby cathedral. SCP-090 was removed, the cathedral burned, 6 monks and the priest were terminated. SCP-090 has been located at site since the retrieval. Object's initial location prior to the cathedral is unrecorded. SCP-090 is a black cubic structure, 20 centimeters by 20 centimeters by 20 centimeters, made of an unknown ceramic material. Object is classified as indestructible, following tests outlined in Document 090B, unattached. Each side is divided into 10,000 individual squares, an arrangement similar to a Rubik's Cube, 100 segments per edge, each segment 2 millimeters wide. Each square has part of a design etched into the surface. Etchings glow white. Unknown internal structure causes the realignment of a single row or column roughly every 2.8 seconds. Vague records of the object's alignments have been kept since 1242 CE, but those kept before 1533 CE have been lost. Modern technology has allowed the exact alignments to be imaged and recorded, as well as studied. Segments are divided by a thin white line, unless they are aligned correctly with the square directly adjacent to them. There are 22 correct alignments on the object's surface currently. D023016 is currently the only alignment of 3 adjacent segments on the surface of SCP-090. B100023 and C043077 are the 4 segment alignments. There is also a 6 segment alignment. Full item completion has been hypothesized to cause an unparalleled disaster to occur. Addendum: Document 090A, Dr. Experiment Notes. Experiment 0012. Observation is going well. We have managed to develop a system to record and analyze the shifts in the cube almost as quickly as they occur. No correlation between shifts and any world events found yet. Experiment 0048. We observed a 6-segment alignment today on the first side. It was noted and passed without incident. 2 hours later, a research assistant returned from the break room with news that a tsunami had occurred in the Indian Ocean and caused hundreds of thousands of deaths and extensive property damage. No correlation is currently known, but we will make note of it. Experiment 0150. After our 112th alignment on the fourth side of the cube and 120th accident report in the lab, we are designating the fourth side as local and will implement safety measures tomorrow. Staff are discouraged from making bets regarding the outcome of alignments. Experiment 0172. A 6-segment alignment was recorded this morning on the local side. As a safety precaution, site was evacuated. 2 hours later, a containment breach occurred that resulted in no loss of life due to the evacuation. Object determined to predict events, not cause them. First side designated as global. Upgrade to Euclid status requested. Experiment 0240. We stepped up our experiments today by attempting to modify the cube itself. When D-class personnel attempted to make a shift, SCP-090 immediately created a 10-segment alignment of its own accord near the top left corner of the local side. Exactly 2 hours later, SCP broke containment and data expunged. 2 agents were also lost during the incident. Recommended forced shift testing of SCP-090 postponed. Upgrade to Keter status approved. as SCP-090 is obviously capable of causing events of its own accord. Object may be sentient. Item number, SCP-167. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-167 is currently kept in room of Research Command 06. Its door is to be padlocked at all times when not under study. Anyone wishing to obtain the key to conduct unscheduled exploration of, or to study SCP-167, may do so only with the permission of the relevant Level 3 personnel assigned to this SCP. Description: SCP-167 is a cube, measuring approximately 10 meters on its edge, created from an unidentified shiny white plastic polymer. Affixed to one of the faces of the cube is a large metal door. It is unknown if this door is part of the original SCP, or if it was affixed by someone else before the object was acquired by the SCP Foundation. The interior dimensions of this cube are identical to the exterior, minus several centimeters for the width of the cube, except that two of the remaining three walls each have doorways in them. These doorways lead directly to identical rooms, each with two more doorways leading to more identical rooms. This pattern continues for as far as the research teams have been able to determine. The placement of these doorways appears to be random. No pattern has been found that explains which two of the three remaining walls have doors. SCP-167 shows signs of being explored before. A number of rooms, especially those at a low depth, have red dots or other markers painted next to the doorway back to the entrance. Researchers have recently taken to replicate this behavior on any rooms they visit, after the events mentioned in Document Number 167-08. Additionally, several man-made and natural objects have been found scattered in some of the rooms of SCP-167. Religious idols, circa 500 BCE. Several treasure chests, circa 1500 CE. Data expunged. And several SCPs, most notably, data expunged. Addendum 167-01. SCP-167 does not appear to follow the rules of Euclidean geometry. A different path to rooms which should be the same room was taken by two researchers. Both arrived at their destination, but neither saw nor heard the other. How SCP-167 is warping space to create this effect is unknown, but warrants further study. Addendum 167-02. A request to test the effects of SCP-184 on SCP-167 has been suggested. This experiment is under consideration. Addendum 167-03. A request to use SCP-167 as a compact storage space for benign SCPs has been proposed by Dr. This proposal requires a reclassification of SCP-167 to Safe Class, so a re-evaluation is pending. Document 167-08. As most of you are aware, Dr. was videotaped entering SCP-167 several days ago, without the requisite ball of twine, and he has not yet returned. His ultimate fate is unknown, but the search teams have turned up nothing. Let this be a reminder to all of you just how easy it could be to get lost in there if you don't utilize some method of marking your path. If I find that any other researcher has disobeyed the safety regulations and entered without a ball of twine, no matter how far or deep they intend to go, they will find themselves being transferred to another facility for researching Keter Class SCPs, where they should have ample motivation to learn to follow safety regulations quite quickly. Dr. Klein. Item number, SCP-345. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-345 is to be kept inside a secure vault at site. Seeing as the object is inert by itself, no further containment is necessary. Personnel seeking to solve SCP-345 need the permission of one Level 2 personnel. SCP-345-1 is to be kept inside a 5-meter by 5-meter by 5-meter sealed room on site. Following Incident 345-1, personnel are only allowed to solve one of the six faces of SCP-345. Trying to solve all faces will result in reassignment to MTF Epsilon-8. The Midwives. Description: SCP-345 is a stone cube whose faces are each divided into 9 squares of equal size, and sections of which can be rotated in a fashion similar to a common puzzle toy. Each face of the cube measures 5.7 centimeters. Instead of the normal 6 colors commonly found in this kind of puzzle, the squares represent 6 different materials: an intrusive magmatic rock resembling granite, an intrusive magmatic rock resembling gabbro, an extrusive magmatic rock resembling basalt, a sedimentary rock resembling sandstone, volcanic glass resembling obsidian, and a high-grade metamorphic rock resembling granite gneiss. SCP-345 can be opened by forcibly pulling its sides apart. The cube is hollow, possessing a circular cavity 4.5 centimeters in diameter in its center. If left open for 5 seconds, SCP-345 will automatically close and shuffle itself for 2 minutes. Afterward, it may be safely handled. Note that it will not be possible to force SCP-345 open after the shuffling takes place. Solving SCP-345 is no harder than solving the common versions of the puzzle. However, if one of the faces becomes complete, one of the following situations may occur. If the completed face represents one of the magmatic rocks, SCP-345 will heat up to approximately either 1500 degrees Celsius, gabbro face, 1200 degrees Celsius, basalt face, or 900 degrees Celsius, granite face. The amount of time SCP-345 takes to cool down also greatly varies, with the basalt face being the fastest, up to 50 minutes, and the gabbro face being the slowest, up to 250 days. If the completed face represents the sedimentary rock, the cube will start shaking violently for up to 10 hours. The sound of either water running or wind howling can be heard coming from inside SCP-345 during the whole process. If the completed face represents volcanic glass, SCP-345 will heat up to approximately 900 degrees Celsius and will take up to 5 minutes to cool down. If the completed face represents the metamorphic rock, SCP-345 will suffer the same process that would happen if the granite face was completed. After cooling down, the cube will proceed to shuffle itself at high speeds, making loud grinding sounds while it does so, for up to 50 hours. After one of the processes is over, SCP-345 can be opened again, and a sculpture made of the same material that was represented by the completed face can be found inside of it. The small sculpture will always be of a planet or planetoid 4.5 centimeters in diameter. These sculptures do not resemble any currently known planet. If more than one face is completed at the same time, both corresponding processes will occur, one followed by the other. The statue created will be made of both materials. For instance, the sculpture created by completing the granite and obsidian faces at the same time had its continents made of granite and its oceans made of obsidian. SCP-345 was recovered by a Foundation agent on date undisclosed, days after the eruption of the volcano in Ecuador. Said agent claims to have found it near the base of the volcano and took it as a curiosity. He learned about the true nature of the SCP after trying to solve it, suffering third-degree burns in the process. Incident 3451. On date undisclosed, while Dr. tested SCP-345, she managed to complete all faces by not opening the cube once a face was completed. SCP-345 proceeded to rumble for 3 minutes, after which it opened by itself. A small metal sphere, 4.5 centimeters in diameter, emerged from inside SCP-345 and hovered 3 meters from the ground. Shortly after, the sphere began rotating, accelerating to a rate of 5 meters a second. Strong gravitational forces were detected in the vicinity of the sphere, visibly affecting objects up to 15 meters away. Seconds later, a dense orange liquid with an average surface temperature of approximately 4,000 degrees Celsius began flowing from SCP-345, which proceeded to encompass the metal sphere. Afterward, another, denser liquid began flowing out of SCP-345. It also proceeded to encircle the sphere. This liquid continued to flow from inside SCP-345 until the sphere reached a diameter of 2.3 meters, at which point the flow stopped, and SCP-345 automatically closed. The resulting sphere was still slowly spinning and hovering above the ground. It was extremely dense, and its gravitational pull was strong enough to severely damage its surroundings. The temperature at the surface varied between 900 and 1600 degrees Celsius. 30 minutes later, parts of the outermost magma began to cool down, solidifying into a thin rock crust. 20 hours later, most parts of the sphere were solid rock, with small seas of lava flowing between them. Little volcanoes and mountains could also be observed. At this point, a special containment team with heat-resistant equipment was moved in to relocate the sphere to a safer room. The sphere was later designated SCP-345-1. Studies regarding the probability of its eventual development of an atmosphere are underway. Note: although at first we thought that SCP-345 had created a copy of Earth, as of date undisclosed, studies have shown that it is unlikely that SCP-345-1 will develop an atmosphere, and the composition of its magma is very different from Earth's, containing far smaller quantities of silica and aluminum, and larger amounts of titanium. It is currently unknown if the magma of other planetoids created by SCP-345 would have a similar composition. Perhaps we should have a D-class completed, preferably on an open field. Dr. Lesson complete. To continue with your orientation training, subscribe to SCP Orientation right now, and make sure you don't miss any of our upcoming videos.